Gabby. I bring greetings to you from the Lord God. He wants you to know that you are amazing, inside and out. Sorry, Mary, try to relax. I know you've got a lot on your mind at the moment, but I needed to let you know something very important. God has a big surprise for you. You are going to become pregnant, and you will give birth to a son and call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High God. The Lord God will make him a king, and he will rule over his kingdom forever.
You realize Joey and I aren't even married yet? Tell me you're kidding me.
Well, no and yes. The Holy Spirit, he will indeed kid you, as in give you a kid, but no ordinary kid. This child will be conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and he will be called the Son of God. God is in the business of keeping his promises, and I assure you that this will happen exactly as I have told you.
Okay, I mean, if this is God, then I'm cool with that. May his will be done in my life.
You're kidding me.
No, I'm not. And you're not kidding me either. It's the Holy Spirit. The angel said the Holy Spirit would come upon me. The Holy Spirit is going to give me a baby. Actually, I think I'm pregnant already.
Well, this makes things awkward, doesn't it? You're doing your HSC, I'm doing my building apprenticeship. It's not like we're flush with cash anyway to support a family. Mary, what will our parents say? And what will the church think? There are other ways we can deal with this, you know. Mary, I need you to tell me straight. Are you sure this pregnancy is from God?
Joey. Joey. Mary is not kidding you. This is for real. The baby that is living in her has come from the Holy Spirit. This baby will be called Jesus, and he will save people from their sins. This baby will be nicknamed Emmanuel, which means God with us. So bring forward your wedding date, Joey, because I want you to marry Mary now.
Time anyone has loved me. right foot. Menzies will score! Menzies! He is over to score!
Joey. I don't think we can go to State of Origin this year.
But I go to State of Origin every year. It's my annual pilgrimage. I've got to go.
I'm looking on Airbnb and there's nothing. There's nowhere to stay.
You're kidding me. There must be something. I just have to go to State of Origin.
Everything is so expensive. And the only thing that I can even find available is a camper van in Manly.
Camper van? Well, I guess that'll have to do. As long as the baby doesn't arrive.
Wah, 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 wah.
Girl, use my manger for your darling angel. Cause you're then my sheep, you are to be. Mary showed you my stable for my farming animals. Girl, you must spend the night with these, maybe.
Life is one big party when there's children, but who's gonna have a bed for your small son? Yeah. It's all good that your little one's near, but can't find a room, crud, water broken, now what? Yeah. You can rush off to the place I mentioned, spend the night, save the money for the rent, and yeah, keep them here through your entire vacation. You won't need reservations, my mom's pretty...
You're kidding me.
What is it, Neville?
You're kidding me. I found it.
For Pete's sake, Neville, what have you found?
Gentlemen, we all know that gravitational waves are ripples in the curvature outward from their source at the speed of light.
Right.
We also know that these minuscule ripples in the fabric of space-time have only been detected in the last few years, though they were predicted by Albert Einstein in 1916.
Yes, but proving gravitational waves are real are completely different things to finding their sources.
Then look at that!
Look at what?
Come here! Zoom in. Ready?
It's a camper van?
And you're saying that this is the source of the gravitational waves?
The signal coming from that van at intervals of 100 seconds is 15 times longer than any other gravitational wave ever detected. We don't know what is causing this cosmic disturbance, but we do know that it's coming from this van. Gentlemen, this is a game changer. This will revolutionize the way we look at everything.
But where's the van parked?
Using the process of triangulation, we can pinpoint the location to within 20 kilometers.
Saddle up your camels, boys. We're off to Sydney.
I'll send my S.O. into the world. I'll send my S.O. into the world. I hope that someone gets mine. I hope that some will get mine. I know that some will get my
message in the Bible, yeah. Message in the Bible, yeah.
Oh, Mary, he's beautiful.
Yes, Joey, but you're missing State of Origin.
Mary, there's some things more important than sports, and this is one of them. I'm sorry I couldn't provide you with anything grander. It seems such a humble birthplace for the Son of God.
It's fine, really. It's just fine. It's just the way he would want it.
In a place that some reviled, manger with the black sheep, a holy child. No one knows who he is, he's not yet famous.
work, buddy.
Yeah. I'll do this one. Oh, Tessa, did you watch State of Origin, bud?
Too right. Lost again. Bloody Queenslanders.
Oh, you're kidding me, mate. Oh, 16 losses on the trot. Can't believe it. I reckon we bring back Andrew Johns.
Mate, we totally need a miracle, that's for sure.
Did I hear something about a miracle?
What the?
This day, in the city of Sydney, a saviour has been born. He is Christ the Lord. He will bring lasting peace to the world and forgiveness of sin. So don't go all weak at the knees. This is the best news you could ever hear. This good news will bring joy to all people. So go to Manly, and there you will find a baby wrapped in a beach towel and lying in a van.
My lord.
Cheryl, what do you know about this baby Jesus?
Well, nothing much more than you do, my lord mayor.
This tradie, Tezza, he's created a fan page for him and this baby Jesus. And in a matter of days, it's got over 1 million likes. And this photo he shared of him and the baby, it's got 80,000 likes and shares in 2 days. That's considerably more than my likes and shares on my page. You know that, don't you, Cheryl?
That's what they call viral. It's all over social media. Something about celestial events and this person being Christ, this person being the Lord.
But there's only one Lord of Sydney. And that's me!
Yes, my Lord, you are the Lord. There is no other.
Then who is this imposter? And where is he?
Is that the office of Clovermore?
Yes.
Ah, good morning. We are three wise scientists from CSIRO in Parks. We have come to discover the source of gravitational waves. We believe this could be the biggest event to happen in the city of Sydney, possibly in the world. It could have something to do with an ancient prediction concerning a baby who was also the Lord. We thought that we should come here to find out more, you know, you being a lord and all.
This is Clovermore, Lord Mayor of Sydney. I'm very interested in your story. Why don't you come on up and we can discuss it? I'd be very interested in helping you with this fabulous quest. Very interesting story. Very interesting. Camper vans, you say? Just a moment. Roger, Clover. You do a search on camper vans in the Sydney area for me, please. Mm-hmm. Yeah, interesting. Okay, thank you, Roger. Well, it seems there's a predominance of camper vans in the suburb of Manly. So I suggest you start there. Off you go. Actually, I'd quite like to see this Lord, you know, worship him and all that. So why don't you go, find out exactly where he is, come back and tell me, and then I'll go with you. I'd love to join you in this quest. Very special. Okay, off you go. See you soon.
You. Cheryl, get the ABC on the phone. Tell them we have a story they may be interested in. Our precious Lord is a fraud, and the public need to know.
You're kidding me! This is amazing! Ever since I did my history project on the pyramids in Year 9, I've wanted to come to Egypt. This can be our honeymoon, Joey.
I'm sorry it's not under more pleasant circumstances.
That clover moor is a real piece of work, hey? That story on 7:30 report was wrong on so many levels.
And don't forget what they said about our little baby on Q&A. Just terrible.
Well, at least we'll be safe here from the media. How long before we can go back, do you think?
The angel didn't tell me that part. Perhaps I'll have another dream.
Speaking of dreams, I have a dream.
What's that?
That all people might believe and know that this Jesus truly is the Messiah, the Son of God, and in the act of believing, have life and life to the full.